Deputy Shane Ross.
Thank you, Ken Cullen. Taoiseach, I wonder, would you consider sending a note of congratulations to the Greek Prime Minister, Mr. Antonis Samaras, for the stroke he pulled last night in getting an enormous amount of the Greek debt implicitly written off. Indeed, the Prime Minister today described it as a great victory. It's time, I think, that Ireland could proclaim in its own debt negotiations a great victory, because we have one important thing in common with Greece, and that is that we both nations, have unsustainable level of debt. The Greeks seem to have now worked that to their advantage. We seem to have found it very difficult to do so. While Greece celebrates today, we sit on the sidelines as spectators on this great deal. I wonder, Taoiseach, did you hear Morning Ireland this morning when the chairman of the European Monetary Affairs and Economics Committee stated that Ireland now had a raw deal on the Anglo promissory notes in light of the Greek deal? And I can understand when you resist pleas from this side of the House to take unilateral action on the Anglo deal. But when it's coming from impartial key people in the European community, I think it's time that you listen, because the deal done last night was spectacular. The deal implicitly writes off some of the Greek debt in 2016 to 2020. It gives them interest rates on some of their loans of virtually nothing, 50 basis points. It extends their loans. This is something which we have completely and utterly failed to achieve. And while what I'd like to ask you is this. What has Greece got that we don't have? Greece has eyeballed the European community, the EU, and the IMF, and we haven't managed to do it. And I think, Taoiseach,
will you allow the deputy complete his question, please?
In the light of the Greek deal, would you be prepared to tell the European Union, the European Commission, and the IMF that we will not be paying those promissory notes on the 31st of March? They would stand up and listen to us the way they stood up and listened to Greece last night.
Thank you.
Or indeed the way that people are encouraged to pay €25 to go and listen to you in your scripted role down in Borth Gash as one of the four angry men.
To leaders' questions, please. Thank you.
Pay up.
Thank you. Thank you.
I might say to Deputy Ross, I don't know whether that's a rewriting of the script for the four angry men, but anyway, it's a different position than what was being said some months ago, that Greece would default, that Greece would be driven out of the euro, that there would be a catastrophic situation here. This is a decision made by the Eurozone ministers to see that Greece maintains its position as a member of the Eurozone and can work its way out of its difficulties. Now, I think it's understandable that the Greek situation is an entirely different position than Ireland or indeed than Portugal. And we've separated those over the last 12 months, which is recognised right across the world as Greece being in a very different position than our country here. You are aware. What have they got, Deputy? The tax-free threshold for income tax has been lowered from €12,000 to €5,000 in Greece. A married couple with one earner in Ireland only enters the income tax net at €24,750, single person at €16,500. The number of public sector job cuts in Greece will be 150,000 by 2015. Any public service reductions here were by voluntary situation. Monthly pensions above €1,000 in Greece will be cut by 20%. The minimum wage has been cut by 20% from 751 a month to 600 euro. And the Greek government have to raise 11 billion from privatisation by 2016 solely to pay down debt. Now, the attendance of the Minister for Finance yesterday in Brussels means that the decision that was made does not mean that Ireland is a contributor to this position insofar as Greece is concerned. You're aware that we contributed over 350 million in bilateral loans. We're not required either to return profits or to return interest. That's a recognition of the very different situation that Greece is in. And for your information again, Deputy Ross, let me repeat that there is a great deal of work going on, both in terms of the preparation for the legal framework, for the consequence of the decision on the 29th of June, severing the link between sovereign and bank debt, and also in respect of the promissory notes with the ECB. It is the intention of the Minister for Finance on behalf of the government not to have to pay the 3 billion in March of 2013. And it's in that regard that discussions are continuing to take place with the European Central Bank. I noted Deputy Martin's comments recently on the conclusion of the European Council report. He said these are things that could be restructured quite easily. It's a bit Irish, really, coming from what was the most extraordinary economic decision ever foisted on the backs of the Irish people.
Thank you.
And I can tell you this, Deputy Ross,
thank you.
It does take time, and diligence and patience to get a sense of trust and confidence and belief from others that they should help us. And that recognition is now there, and we will continue, Deputy Ross, with those discussions to bring about a situation where that level of debt can be re-engineered in the country's interest.
Deputy Ross.
Thank you.
Would you mind for Deputy Ross, please? Thank you.
Thank you, Kirkhill.
That applies to both sides of the House. Thank you. Deputy Ross. Do not hear me, please. I ask for Deputy Ross, please. Would you please?
Thank you.
They're looking for free tickets.
Kirkhill, I'd like to respond, first of all, to Deputy Rabbit for
Deputy Rabbit. Deputy Rabbit, our Minister Rabbit, would you please?
There is a bigger audience there than there is here, I can assure you, when he's speaking. And on top...
You now have 45 seconds left, if you want to ask yourself.
Thank you, can't call it. The problem, I think, Taoiseach, is this. We talk about Greece as having a special position. We talk about Ireland as having a special position. Greece's special position has gained them some unique concessions. And would you tell the House two things? And very directly, do you regard, and I'd love to hear a government spokesman absolutely specific on this, Ireland's debt now as unsustainable? Okay? And secondly, will you, as a result of that, look for the same terms as Greece and not just park the Anglo promissory note which you talked about there, but will you actually declare that we are now not paying it? You're nearly there in what
Thank you
said. Would you declare that Ireland will not be paying that on the 31st of March?
Thank you. Taoiseach, 1 minute.
Well, as I said before, the intent of the government is to bring about a situation where we get agreement for a re-engineering of the promissory note situation insofar as the former Anglo-Irish Bank is concerned. If you like, it's a replacement of a bank overdraft with a very long-term mortgage. And it's in that space that the discussions being undertaken by the Minister for Finance and his officials continue with the European Central Bank, with a view to arriving at a position that we do not have to pay 3 billion in March of 2013. We've said that before, and it's in that area, Deputy Ross, that the discussions continue to take place with the European Central Bank. You yourself will have heard the public comments from other political leaders, from other ministers for finance, from the European Commission, from the IMF, and so on. So there is an understanding of the enormous challenge that this has placed on the backs of Irish taxpayers, and it is not just to get recognition of that, our understanding of it, but to get a decision that would bring about a re-engineering of that level of debt before March 2013 is the objective of government here. And believe you me, there are a great deal of discussion going on about that, and I hope that that can be achieved in the interests of our people here and of our country. I have to say that it's well recognised, Deputy, that since Ireland was, if you like, first out the gate here, that this has been an enormous burden placed on our people. That's recognised. It's to follow that recognition through to a decision in our country's interests where we are. What's happened in Greece, if you like, is a menu of decisions made about the Greek situation. That menu is there for all to see and to examine. Our position is in a different space here, but clearly everybody understands what was done here in the case of Greece. Our discussions are about concession in a different area, which is a re-engineering of the promissory notes.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.